Hey, what's up, guys? Yes, I just wanted to kind of make an update because I feel like I've been needing to make an update. The update is that I'm going to be undergoing chemo for 6 months, and after that 6 months, I believe there's going to be a 4 month break, and we're going to reevaluate, reassess, you know, whatever we got to do and see like what's going on, how my body's reacting and all that sort of stuff. I'm sure like we'll have check-ins during that 6 months with my cancer doctor, but that starts on October 29th, and I'm excited to get this show on the road. So I have breast cancer stage 2, grade 3, which means it's aggressive, and the doctor said that usually with the aggressive ones, it's more likely that they'll go away faster with the chemo treatment. I think the only times that I've kind of felt a little bit sad was one, I mean, this is gonna get personal however way you slice it, but like one, because sometimes I'll get emotional like when I'm getting biopsied, because I had the biopsy done on each side of my breast. I kind of started tearing up and feeling sorry for myself when that happened. And then today I got a biopsy of my liver because something had kind of lit up when I did my CT scans. So they wanted to biopsy that to make sure that there was no cancer in my liver. I thought it was my kidney, but I guess they're both kind of in the same area. Okay, so I was talking about my treatment. I am going to be starting treatment on the 29th of October, which is next week. It's coming up really fast, which I am excited to get this show on the road. I want to get this all over with and get back to my normal scheduled life. But before we do the treatment, because I'm young, I talked to a fertility specialist, and he had given me some options about how to preserve my eggs. And the one that I chose, which I thought was, because there's a lot of things up in the air when you freeze your eggs, and like there's just like so many things, so many variables, and I was just like, I feel like that's so much work for an unknown success rate for me, you know. I have full faith that they have had high success rates and had the ability to get women pregnant with freezing eggs and stuff, but I just, for me and my personal journey and what is going on with me, I think that wouldn't be the best route, because I would be afraid that I go through that process and freeze the eggs and keep them in storage for 5+ years or so, and then try to get pregnant with those eggs, and then that not work out for me, and I just wasted all that money, or whoever's money, because there's financial aid grants and whatever things for that as well. So I just didn't want to go that route because I felt like it was too risky. So what I'm doing is I'm going to be doing an ejection, which I believe is more so they do that for men, and then there's a risk of like if I do it longer than 6 months, my bones will be dense permanently, I believe, which kind of freaks me out. And then at the same time, I'm like, wait, what about my skating career? Not that I'm a pro or anything, but like, you know, it's a hobby that I'm passionate about. And like, if I go skating, am I gonna break a bone if I just normally fall? Like, I have a scab here that happened like, what, 2 weeks ago? And like, if I did something that simple, would that actually break my bones? I'm kind of worried about that, but they say it should be fine if I'm only doing it for 6 months, which is the plan. And so I'm gonna be doing that on Monday before the Thursday that I'm starting chemo. So I wish I would change my freaking calendar on the wall like a good adult, but I'm not a good adult. I barely know what appointments I'm going to, what times, what locations I'm going to. There's so many appointments, I just can't wrap my head around it sometimes. I'm just like, where do I need to be? What is this appointment for? I don't know. Like this morning when I was going for the biopsy, I thought they were gonna biopsy my lymph nodes. I didn't realize it was a biopsy for my liver. Okay, so let's talk about the appointments. For the Mediport, I was given Tylenol and some other drug to help me relax. relax pain and stuff. And that one, I didn't really feel the drugs, which is a good thing. I was just relaxed like they said I would be. I was kind of scared because I've heard people dying off of fentanyl, which I'm sure they're not getting dosed properly, you know? So I just was like kind of worried about that. But then I was like, you know, they're doctors, they know how to dose people. And then they probably gave me the same drugs when they were doing my biopsy of my liver this morning. But this time I felt it, and I mean, I was under the supervision of doctors and nurses, so like it wasn't like on purpose or anything like that, but I did kind of like, I guess, get a little high off of it, which was, you know, a little fun rush for me. But, you know, I'm not like out here seeking street drugs, like I'm fine. After the procedure, which I was really scared about, I was worried about, I was like, because my mom had talked to a retired oncologist and he said that it sounded like it was so abrasive, and like when I actually went in for it and like came out and stuff, it wasn't as bad as I thought it was gonna be, so there's that. So afterwards they had me in recovery for 2 hours, which I basically slept the whole time because I got up at like 4 a.m. because it was like, oh my gosh, I need to like get ready and stuff like that. Even though I was told to fast, so I did not eat. And I was like, why am I getting up? I don't have, like, I just did makeup because they told me I could wear makeup. So I just got ready. I had like a drink of water and like that was it. And then, so I slept the whole time after for 2 hours in recovery. And then by the time my mom was supposed to pick me back up, I woke up. So that was nice. So I was tired off the drugs, and I was tired because I was just tired. That's what I was getting at. Then the only thing I really had to eat today was at, what, like 2 o'clock? And I had avocado toast, which is my favorite now. And then I'm probably gonna make myself something to eat for dinner, and then I'll probably go to bed, and then I'll be going to work tomorrow. Oh, that's another thing I should touch on, is work. So I was originally gonna try to take a leave of absence from work because now I'm immune compromised, and getting sick from other people kind of scares me, especially with what's going on in the world today. Because we don't have 50 associates in a 75-mile radius, means that my store's location legally doesn't qualify for medical leave, unfortunately. I'm a part of this Facebook group and had asked them if anyone else had worked while going through chemo, and I've gotten a few replies on people who had. Some were actually nurses, so that kind of made me feel better. So instead of medical leave, I'm on Americans with Disabilities Act with my work, and because I work in the stockroom, I'll be limited on my interaction with customers, so that's a good thing as well. I know no one really is making me make these videos, but I hope I answer some of your questions and concerns about my medical health and treatment process. And as for my mental health, I just try not to dwell on the bad stuff because I know where that can take me. Plus, I think I've come to accept everything that's been thrown at me anyways. Well, I hope everybody has enjoyed this video. Please like, comment, and subscribe. I will also link my GoFundMe page and my merch. I have a merch line with Teesprings, and the proceeds from my merch line will go to towards medical bills and other necessities that I might need. Thank you, and I'll see you next time. Bye!